Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today we're going to continue learning about soloing patterns with a total fretboard freedom shape. And if you do it for around 3 minutes a day for a couple of weeks, it is going to make a big difference in your soloing. The reason why is this shape uses one group of scale tones in a uniform layout, and it can apply to any key anywhere along the fingerboard. In this lesson, we'll learn the shape, how to get started with some phrase builder melody, and we'll also hear how this shape sounds when it gets applied over a jam track. Now, in the second half of this lesson on your Patreon video, I'll take this idea one step further by showing you how this fretboard freedom shape relates to the modes. Plus, along with that, I'll have two more jam tracks for you. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. We're going to use the key of A for our examples, but keep in mind that this pattern really, it could work for any key. You could just move it around, it's geometrical. We're going to get started by going through the full shape using the key of A. So that's the entire shape across the whole fretboard area. The scale does cover two full octaves. We've got an octave down here and an octave up here off of the A notes. And we're going to break it apart though and do some phrase builder lines. Check it out. Here's the upper register phrase builder. And here's the lower register. So let's check these things out, because phrase builder lines are a really great way to use as a springboard to take you to the days of actually building your licks and your soloing using some kind of new scale shape like this, you know, fretboard freedom shape we're working on here in the key of A. So let's just take a look at that upper register line. It goes like this. Okay, slowly it starts on the 10th fret A, second string. We're gonna jump up here to the E note on 12th fret first string. Do a pull off of 10 to 9, pardon me. And then we'll have a 12th fret, 10 and 9 on the second string, and then 11th fret, third string with a slide down 9 to 7. We'll grab a 9th fret, fourth string, and then slide down 7 to 6 to resolve on an A note. So the phrase building idea is we're taking the notes of the scale and we're trying to create something melodic, but at the same time, something like an exercise too. Later, what'll happen is these will just slowly become licks and lines for your soloing. Now let's take a look at the lower register line that we have. Once again, it goes like this. So we're starting on the A at the 7th fret, 4th string. We're doing a pull off over to the G sharp, so 7 to 6 on that 4th string. And then we have a 9th fret F sharp on 5th string, back to the G sharp 6th fret 4th string, and then we're going to slide down from an E to a D on the 7th fret to 5th fret of 5th string, and we're also going to bring in a 4th fret C sharp on that 5th string, so it goes 7, 5, 4. Then we'll have the 7th fret 6th string B, coming back around to the 4th fret C sharp on 5th string once again, and then we'll have A to G sharp back to the A to finish off and do the resolution of those low register tones. So once more. Alright, so now we've got these phrase builder lines that we put together here, and you're becoming more acquainted with the scale from a perspective of creating music with it and making it melodic. The next thing that we want to do is put it to work. So what I have here for you is a backing jam track in the key of A. You'll get this if you're a Patreon member. So it'll be A major, down to E, then taking that down further to a D, and then we're going to do A to E with G sharp in the bass, and then head back to the A chord once again. If you're not familiar with a chord that would give you E with G sharp in the bass, probably one of the most famous voicings on guitar is basically to take the E chord that you'd have, like a D chord, but, you know, made movable and then moved up to the second position. I cover this stuff in my intermediate guitar program over on creativeguitarstudio.com, but I just am taking a D chord, sliding it up to second position, making it an E chord now, and then I'm taking the high G sharp note and I'm just putting it down in the bass, and now I've got a warmer sound from that E major chord. It's an E chord with a G sharp down below, and it's a really nice sound to take you back to A in this key. So that's the jam track. What I'm going to do is fire up the loop pedal with that jam track on it right now. And basically, what I'm going to do is fool around with the scale shape and just try to come up with some lines and licks and music using it, okay? Here we go. So as you can tell, there's not a lot to this. You have to get used to the shape, use your phrase builders to get you acquainted with some more melodic contour to what's going on with the pattern on the neck. The pattern on the neck, you know, it's just kind of generic, you know. The thing about it that's kind of interesting, though, is we do have these half-step, whole-step motions that are continuous through the shape, you know, G-sharp to A, and then a whole step to the B, C sharp to D with the whole step to the E, and then it just continues, G sharp A, B, C sharp D, E, and again, G sharp A, B, C sharp D, E. The only difference is going to be that F sharp note. We can have it there, or, you know, we can replace its location over here and even add a low F sharp down there. But that is getting you into some of the topics that we're going to cover in the Patreon lesson, because what I'm going to do in the Patreon is take this shape, you know, right now it's operating, you know, completely as an A major shape, but we're going to expand upon its use in the Patreon, because I want to get you going on some modes. So we're going to look at, you know, some sounds of the F sharp Aeolian. We're going to take you into some sounds of B Dorian. I'm going to teach you like how to sort of rearrange that F sharp note in this case to look at the mode a little bit differently and give you a little more freedom to access across the neck so that you can really use this shape to give you that fretboard freedom that we're after with it. So I look forward to joining with you next to go through all these ideas on modes and more jam tracks and get you the jam tracks to all this stuff over on my Patreon. It's a $15 membership over there a month, and you get tons of stuff in there. We got hundreds of lessons in there now. I think we're pushing towards 300 lessons on the Patreon. So there's tons of stuff to access, lots of downloads, a gazillion jam tracks to go and check out. But join me over there at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Also, remember, I do have a website with courses on it. It's creativeguitarstudio.com. I got my beginner, intermediate, advanced courses. We've got an acoustic guitar program. There's a soloing course, guitar technique course on there, music theory stuff. There's just tons of stuff on it. Go and check it out. It's at creativeguitarstudio.com. You're going to love it. And remember to follow me on Patreon, because remember, that's where this part two videos are at, and that's where you're going to get all your jam tracks for these lessons. So I look forward to seeing you next on Patreon. One more time, it's patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I'll take this idea one step further by showing you how this one uniform soloing shape can relate to a couple of modes. Plus, I'll demonstrate how to use this modal fretboard freedom idea to start soloing over some modal jam tracks. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.